The Constitution of India, Preamble. We, the people of India, having solemnly resolved to constitute India into a sovereign, socialist, secular, democratic republic and to secure to all its citizens justice, social, economic and political, liberty of thought, expression, belief, faith and worship, equality of status and of opportunity, and to promote among them all fraternity, assuring the dignity of the individual and the unity and integrity of the nation. In our Constituent Assembly, this 26th day of November 1949, do hereby adopt, enact and give to ourselves this Constitution.
Hello, my dear children. Happy to meet you again. In the previous class, we came across a funny yet beautiful poem titled The Owl and the Pussycat, and also the textual activities, right? Today, let us move on to our next lesson. Before that, let me tell you something. I know that you are enjoying your time at home with your family members. You used to long for holidays when you were at school, but now you wish to join with your friends and be at school with your teachers, right? The relationship between the guru and the disciple is very sacred. The famous quote stresses on the relationship between a guru and a disciple. As you walk with the guru, you walk in the light of existence, away from the darkness of ignorance. Today, we are going to learn a story that highlights the eternal joy that music creates and lays stress on the noble relationship between the guru and the disciple. A story that helps us to learn some important lessons of life. Let us read and enjoy the story. The Song of Songs, written by Swapna Datta. Slowly, gently, the exhausted musician laid his tanpura on the carpet. The exquisite strains of Rag Darbari still vibrated within the hall. Emperor Akbar looked up, his eyes lit with admiration. "Wonderful," he said, "superb. I listen to you every day, but I can't seem to have enough." So, the scene is the court of Akbar, the great emperor of India. Musicians have assembled in the court, and the emperor asked the musician to sing. The hall echoed with a very beautiful Rag Darbari, a raga in Carnatic music. The exhausted musician, that is, the tired musician, slowly and gently kept his tanpura on the carpet. Gently means softly. Even after he stopped singing, the sweetness of the music was still echoing in the hall. The emperor, who was so immersed in the music, looked up with his eyes filled with admiration for the musician. He complimented the musician and said that though he listens to him every day, he wished to hear it again and again. Okay. Tansen, the musician, bowed in silent gratitude. "I think you have the most wonderful voice in the world," said Akbar. "But I don't, Shahanshah," said Tansen with a smile. "There is someone who sings far better than I do." "Really?" cried the disbelieving Akbar. "Then I must have him sing in my court. Can you arrange it?" So children, can you guess who the musician was? Yes, the musician was Tansen, the legendary music composer who invented the Rag Darbari in Carnatic music. So, listening to the comment passed by Akbar, Tansen bowed in silent gratitude. Bow means bend the head down, and gratitude means thankfulness. The emperor praised Tansen, saying that he has the most wonderful voice. But Tansen answered that there is someone else who sings far better than him. But the emperor couldn't believe it and told him to make him sing in his court. Okay? Tansen shook his head. "I am afraid he will not come, sire." What? Not even if he hears that the emperor himself summoned him? No, not even then. This reply would have enraged any other emperor. But Akbar was different. Very well, Ustadji, said Akbar, smiling into Tansen's half-scared eyes. If he doesn't come, I shall go to him myself. Will you take me to him? Yes, sire, provided you do not come as the emperor of Hindustan. I shall go as a humble lover of music. So, Tansen shook his head. I am afraid he will not come, sire. What? Not even if he hears that the emperor himself summoned him? No, not even then. So, when Tansen was asked to make arrangements for his guru to sing in the emperor's court, Tansen told the emperor that he is not sure whether his guru will agree or not. This reply surprised Akbar, knowing that his guru won't come. Okay, this reply would have enraged any other emperor, but Akbar was different. Very well, Ustadji, said Akbar, smiling into Tansen's half-scared eyes. If he doesn't come, I shall go to him myself. Will you take me to him? Yes, sire, provided you do not come as the emperor of Hindustan. I shall go as a humble lover of music. Normally, Tansen's reply would have angered him if it were any other emperor. But Akbar was different. He looked at Tansen with a smile on his face and told him that if his guru could not come to his court, he is ready to go to him. Tansen agreed with the emperor, but also mentioned him not to come as he is the emperor of Hindustan. For this, Akbar told him that he will go as a humble lover of music. Okay, Sanharidas was the man Tansen had spoken of. He had been Tansen's music teacher and he lived the austere life of a hermit. When Tansen and the emperor reached his hut, he was busy with his daily chores. When they asked him to sing, he smiled but said firmly, "I am long past the age for singing." Even his favorite pupil could not persuade him to change his mind. So, Sanharidas was the man Tansen had spoken of. He had been Tansen's music teacher and he lived the austere life of a hermit. When Tansen and the emperor reached his hut, he was busy with his daily chores. So, the person who Tansen was talking about was his music teacher, Sanharidas, who was leading a simple life of a hermit. Austere means simple. And hermit is a person living in solitude as a religious disciple. Okay. So, when Akbar and Tansen reached his hut, his guru was doing his daily works. Okay. When they asked him to sing, he smiled but said firmly, "I am long past the age for singing." Even his favorite pupil could not persuade him to change his mind. When they asked him to sing for them, he denied it politely with a smile, saying that he is long past his age for singing. Not even Tansen, his favorite student, could convince him to sing. Pupil mean student. Okay. But Tansen knew how to get around him. He offered to sing before his guru. And he made a deliberate mistake. "That's not the right note, Tansen," cried his teacher, amazed. "What has happened to you?" Tansen did not seem to understand his teacher. And he made the same mistake again. Exasperated, Sanharidas took the tanpura from Tansen's hands and sang the right note. Then he went on to the next and the next. So, but Tansen knew how to get round him. He offered to sing before his guru. And he made a deliberate mistake. "That's not the right note, Tansen," cried his teacher, amazed. what has happened to you? So Tansen knew how to make his guru sing. So he told that he is ready to sing in front of his guru. And while singing, Tansen made mistake intentionally. He sang the wrong notes intentionally. Deliberately means intentionally or knowingly. Sanharidas was surprised at watching his favorite student making mistake. So he mentioned to him that he was singing the wrong notes. Okay. Tansen did not seem to understand his teacher and he made the same mistake again. Exasperated, Sanharidas took the tanpura from Tansen's hands and sang the right note. Then he went on to the next and the next. Though his guru mentioned him about the wrong notes that he was singing, it looked like Tansen didn't understand what his guru was saying. So he made the mistake again. Getting irritated by his act, Sanharidas took the tanpura from Tansen's hands and sang the right note. He started singing. He didn't stop in one note but kept on singing to the next and the next. Okay? The melody of his voice spread across the forest like the first glimmer of dawn or the fragrance of jasmine. Both Akbar and Tansen listened to him as if they were hypnotized, and the emperor realized that Tansen had spoken the truth. He had not known that music could be like this. He had certainly never heard anything like it before. The melody of his voice spread across the forest like the glimmer of dawn or the fragrance of jasmine. So, the melodious voice of Sanharidas spread across the forest like the first rays of sun or the fragrance of jasmine flower. Glimmer means faint light, cheriya velicham. Both Akbar and Tansen listened to him as if they were hypnotized, and the emperor realized that Tansen had spoken the truth. He had not known that music could be like this. He had certainly never heard anything like it before. So, listening to the melodious voice of Sanharidas, both Akbar and Tansen sat as if they were hypnotized. And at that time, the emperor realized that whatever Tansen said about his guru was true, because he had never heard such music before. Okay? As they walked back, the emperor suddenly broke the silence to ask Tansen, "Why can't you sing like him, Ustad ji?" Tansen smiled. "Shehenshah, I sing at your command, the command of the Emperor of Hindustan. But Guruji sings for the one who is the King of Kings. His music springs from the depths of his soul, free and unasked for. How can my music hope to reach those heights?" So, as they walked back, the emperor suddenly broke the silence to ask Tansen, "Why can't you sing like him, Ustad ji?" So, while coming back from his guru's place, Akbar asked Tansen, "Why can't he sing like his guru?" Tansen smiled, "Shehenshah, I sing at your command, the command of the Emperor of Hindustan. But Guruji sings for the one who is the King of Kings. His music springs from the depths of his soul, free and unasked for. How can my music hope to reach those heights?" Tansen smiled at Akbar and told him that he sings at his command. He sings because the emperor asked him to sing, whereas his guru sings for the ultimate king. He also told him that his guru sings from the depth of his soul, and it comes out of his soul freely and without any compulsion. He sings because he wanted to sing, because he feels like singing, and he could never reach the heights of music that offers guru. Here the story ends. Through the story, the author narrates how Emperor Akbar was enchanted by the wonderful singing of Sanharidas, the music teacher of the court musician Tansen. It also throws light upon the quality of being humble through Tansen's character. Humility is the first thing we must maintain, and Tansen's attitude and behavior towards his guru is worth copying. I hope you enjoyed the story. Go through the story once again to understand it better. We will go through the activities in the next class. Okay. And that's all for the day. I meet you in the next class. Till then, take care. Thank you.